I left my fear by the side of the road. Hear you speak, it won't let go. Fall to my knees as I lift my hands to pray. Got every reason to be here again. Father's heart that draws me in. And all my eyes wanna see is a glimpse of you. All I need is you.
Hallelujah, church. All we need is the Lord. You know, I just rejoice in the Lord. Amen. Rejoicing even within ourselves. Amen. Just to have that inner joy and just to be full of thanks of what the Lord is doing. Amen. You know, we can be in the midst of everywhere. And, you know, just like a tree with branches, I mean, a tree that is very fruitful has branches, I mean, each and every way. That's a full tree. I mean, a tree that is sprouting in every area and every aspect, you know, of every areas. And some of those branches that are extending out, I mean, there's some that are real thick. There's some that are kind of thin. I mean, they're good to whip you with. I don't, when we're growing up, amen, I'm not trying to get out of the of the teaching there, but I tell you what, when my dad said, let me go find a stick, you don't want me to go find a stick, amen. So if I called you to go find a stick, go find me a good one, because don't make me go find a stick, amen. But you know, I'm sharing that with you because there's order, church, amen. There's order, there's growth, and there's change, amen. Where there's order, there's going to be that change, amen. There's going to be the order of the change of things. And, you know, and the blessing of it, church, is that, you know, God is in the order of that growth, of that change, amen. And when we allow the Lord to do the change, I mean, he does the miraculous. I mean, he goes into places and spaces and areas that we can't even cover, that we can't even imagine, over a man's heart, over a man's life, over a man's mind, over even our bodies, amen. Because if we say that we're made by Christ, and if we say that we're the servants of the Lord, if we say that we are and we belong to him, church of the living God, I mean, our God is not dead. He is alive and he is ever so living. He is those living. Amen. Not only is he the living branches, he's the vine. I mean, that the branches grow out of. Amen. And he calls us that we need to abide in the vine. Amen. That we need to abide, that we need to stay connected into Christ and just to feel the growth of that love. You know, I can imagine a tree and even all sources of life goes through dry spells, things that, oh, it seems like there's no life coming out of it. Amen. Come on now, because I'm preaching really good here today. Amen. But I'm just sharing with you that you feel that there's no life coming out of that tree, that there's, you don't see it. Amen. Because you feel the dry spell. You sense, you know, the air is so hard. The it's so cold. You know, everything seems so just doom. Amen. You feel that there is such a darkness. But I'm here to share with you that even in the midst of that darkness, even in that mist, where you feel that there is no growth, you know what? God is beginning a new thing. God is beginning to shine his light in and through your life, that even where that limb that may be broken, hallelujah, God is a God of restoration. God can mend that broken wound, hallelujah. And you know what? He knows how to begin those new birthings, those new longings, those new moving forward and growing forward. And you know what? You may seem like, you know what? I'm growing and I'm growing out of that limb. Hallelujah. But even growing out of that limb, God is so awesome, church, even in that aspect, because when the time is, the time shall give fruit. You shall have that fruit bearing tree. Hallelujah. So I just want to share with you, church, that you may feel that you're in a hardness right now. And you may not even feel that God is seeing this over your matter. But it does matter to Christ. Your life matters to Christ. Every portion and part of your body and the inside of your being, hallelujah, is important to Christ. You know, he says that he knows every hair that's upon our head. So if he sees that as matter, how much more our whole life that matters to Christ? You know, I've been preaching more of Christ for this Christmas season. And I'm praying that the life of Christ will truly just begin to flow within your life. You know, you may feel that there is no sap. But still out of that tree, it has its own mentality of growth in that tree. You know, water can water that tree, but even the tree itself, when a limb gets broken, when something gets hurt, there's a mending inside that tree. So think of this, church, and putting God first. Allow the Lord to be the source of your life. In Jesus' mighty name, amen and amen.
I left my fear by the side of the road. Hear you speak, it won't let go. Fall to my knees as I lift my hands to pray. God, every reason to be here again. Father's heart that draws me in. And all my eyes want to see is a glimpse of you. All I need.